Welcome back to another episode on the channel, guys. You know it's about it. Back at it again into another video. So before I get into the video as well, you know the usual, I have to thank everyone for the support so far. I wouldn't be here without you guys, so I appreciate you guys watching the video, leaving a like, leaving comments in the comment section, because I know these videos are very helpful to people. So just explain how things are gonna happen now going forward for the new year. What I'm going to do is I'm going to schedule my videos them, because seeing that I'm start back working now, I'm kinda short one time, so I will schedule my videos prior to, so you guys can see exactly when the videos them go drop and actually what the videos them go be about. So for people who probably don't want to watch the video, that's up to you. So when I get the edge up, I'm not telling the fan no. But anyway, let's get into the video. So today's video, as you might see by the thumbnail, is somebody bring it up, and I wanted to talk about this a while now. But the thing is that seeing that when I was in training, I never really trained no female. So I know the female thing would have different from my side. I mostly trained with males. Get me a person, in my time I did Alpha Company when I trained at Newcastle. I guess the female would have normally trained. But as you know, things and time change now, so it's kind of different. So the thing is, the person that asked, like, they need want to know how training is for a female. So, me not this person, I'm going to touch upon that, because it's been a while. The reason why I didn't really want to say nothing about it at a point was because most of the things that me see versus hear are not positive, are mostly negative. So I didn't really want to do certain things or say certain things, because I know say it will come off as harsh to some people, and some people go have some form of disagreement, and the last thing I want is for people to lash it up, fight it out in the comment section. But and the truth of the matter is, these are the things that actually are going on training versus female. So, you know, at one point, if most people didn't know, females were barred from joining the army. Get me? But now females come into the mix, and you know that go. So, them have them perks, you know what I'm saying? So, in a training, because you know, enough women go in there and say, oh, because I'm a woman, them go get special treatment, them not go through certain things as man, and them thing, that is where you're completely wrong. The thing is, because in a woman, when you go get more pressure than the man them. Better yet, when you go get the same punishment, the same form of training as what the man them get. You get me? So everybody train as one. Nobody not really train separate. The only thing is that when you live in a separate from one another. So over here, so they occupy by the male them, and over here, so occupy the female them. So every platoon have a female in it. So a female who actually stay with her platoon would be housed, she would you know, different housing for all females. That's why I set up for every female. You get me? But the training overall, it is as vigorous as when you are training with males. Even though it's a bit toned down, because, you know, it's a woman, and women have them type of strength there and such thing as man. So they kind of take it down a notch. But out there, the same fitness, same training, same thing, running a dirty water and them thing there. All of them things. So when you get barred from that, and basically, seeing that when a woman too, the squad corporal mostly pick for one. Because it is a sense where, as me say, woman them fee say, because you're ladies, you're not going to get certain type of treatment where you're wrong. You see me? That is wrong. That is why them love pick on the woman them, the male skull carpet, them love pick on the woman them in the training. Because when I have that stigma them, because, oh, I'm a lady, so them not going to do me nothing rough. And then, trust me, them go rub on out to learn a sick. That's how you see like the numbers are when the amount of females them come in, and then versus the amount of females are graduate, is in the sense where them are weed out the weak one them, because bear in mind, these are persons that you will be going to road with, and you are the persons that as woman and have to watch, you know, on a partner head back and them thing, and you can't go in at work and come like you come in as a soft ride and you come back out as a soft ride. No, you have to come in at training and you're toughen up yourself. I say thing go, you're gonna get injured. The training is going to be rigorous. Don't expect as a female you're going to come in there to get no hanky panky, nobody go pretty up nothing behind them thing. No, and I say go work. Yeah, go in and go put in work. Then I go drill, you know. Then I go push you into an extreme limit. And when you feel like you go give up, then go tell yourself to leave. You have to push yourself as a woman. You have to earn. You have to earn your title as being a JDS soldier. Make the man show the man them say, you have as much right to be there as them. That is how it goes. That is how training as a female is. You see me? If you're not ready for them type of thing, it just makes sense. So don't go in as a female. Don't feel like you're going to get no special treatment. But bear in mind, there are certain things that happen in training which does not make it out of training. And the reason why I say this, and just to make it clear, you know you have males and you have females. And you know certain type of hormones go kick in and you go start feeling some type of way. And I'm going to be completely honest, trainees have sexy trainees up there. Woman and man, squad corporal, have sexy some of my trainees them as well. That is not a lie, it actually happens. till at some point, trainees get pregnant up there, and nobody know how it happened, and all them thing there. But you have to understand, when you say me, when you hear me make the term JDF Yamed, you don't think it's a joke thing, it's a real thing, because you have someone actually just come into the mindset, if you freak down the whole place and get royalty and them thing there, and expect you, if you not do nothing, and make them lower end talk for them, and do most of the work. So I don't want nobody feel say what may I say a lie or things gonna happen. You have trainees in a training actually get pregnant in a training. Get pregnant in a training. Is it? You have them the things that were going in a training. Man and woman up there have sex while in training. And it really look shake up, you know, say you come do your thing. You say you got turn soldier and you can't even roll out. If you say yeah. This is what you want, and this is what you work towards. Because of feelings and the hormones, you just decide to just shake everything and go do certain things. They my type of things that will actually happen in a training, man. And you have to understand, see, as a woman, you can't make them look upon as some form of tool for use and dispose of. You see me? No succumb, because you go have Scott Carper with you, say, yo, we actually push you to chat to you if you don't look decent and say, yo, they can make a go through training and no pressure and nothing and them thing they rare thing. I saw the thing work. I saw you go in a training. Hence, JDF Yamin, the girl that may just go and just use them body as a way to make them get the work and go through the work with no pressure none at all. And when you see me I talk about it already, and if you say it's a joke thing or me just make up things to get views. When I make up nothing to get views, me I tell you the raw facts of it. And people don't know that. So as a female, yes, you go through the same rigorous training as though the male them go through in a training. Nothing going to change. I just got to be the same training. Them go every pick point even more. Training go even more rigorous. Pound. You have to just have a mindset as a female and say, oh, this is what you want and this is what you go for. Don't follow friend and company in it, because that happened. Friend and company, the people that's training and are in a training. Don't follow friend and company and go do what you're supposed to do. Just keep a level head. Go through training, graduate, make your people them proud, and don't make people pressure you and do things you don't feel comfortable with, and make false promises and make you feel like, say, oh, this is the best way. It's not the best way. The work is hard, yes, but at the end of it, it will pay off, and you will reap the benefits of it if you're willing or if you have a motivation or something to drive it. But that's in short what female training is about. Nothing really change. Same farmer training, same thing you go through, knuckles them, bruise up on them thing that you get injured just like a man them, you get pushed hard. Cause me say, for the female them no face, I know hunky punky thing. Hard, rigorous training, same. So I hope this video is helpful to somebody. Hope this video helps someone along the way. So just don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and share the video to someone that you might think the video will be helpful to. You know it's about Ace. Unknown Ace. Out!